I just started learning Flutter because I heard of Flutter as a big thing for mobile app dev. I started learning Java, but Java was...
So I took the chance here at this incredible Flutter event to ask software developers what they actually do. Let's find out from them what they have to say. Can you tell us your name and your role? What do you do?
Okay, my name is Awo Joseph. I'm a full stack software engineer. I'm into cybersecurity as well.
I'm Dami Ola. I'm a software engineer.
Yeah. Okay. Like, what do you do as a software engineer? Like,
okay, so I'm actually a full stack developer.
How did you get yourself into tech?
Since I've been small, I've always wanted to be a computer scientist or computer engineer. Yeah, since like way back primary school. I've never said, okay, I want to be a pilot, I want to be a doctor. From primary school, I've always been like, no, I want to be a computer scientist or engineer. So from a younger age, it has been the drive.
Okay. How did you get into tech, or how did you get your first job?
Okay, so I actually got into tech right after SHS. I was teaching myself programming and what have you and those kind of stuff. So yeah, so my first project, it was two, when I was in the uni, like it was through like a program like this. I met one of the speakers and she was willing to like give me a project to work on and what have you. So yeah, so that it was through like me going to talk to one of the hosts and what have you. Yeah.
Okay. I just started learning Flutter because I heard of Flutter as a big thing for mobile app dev. I started learning Java, but Java was pretty hard to learn, and yeah, there was the whole Objective C thing. But I got it to Flutter at the end. So, yeah.
What are some of the tools you use daily on a daily basis?
Okay, so of course VS Code, where you write the code, GitHub. So yeah, so those are the basic tools you use practically every day. So yeah.
Okay, what are some of the skills or the tools you use in your job?
So for mobile development, I use Flutter. Right, I use Flutter for my mobile development. When it comes to the backend, I use like Django. I use Python as well for automation and all that. And I use AI for my everyday to like debug, or when I run to an error, yeah, AI is my go-to.
Like, what are some of the skills? Like,
skills?
Yeah. Soft skills.
Critical thinking is part of a skill, let me just say. So, just think about what you want to do. It's part of a skill. Another skill to talk about is making research. So
right now we are currently building a product in the insurance space. So I run my own company at the moment. So that's what we do.
What's in terms of salary, or what the range as a full stack developer?
I think this question actually depends. It depends on your level. The company itself and those kind of stuff, so it varies. But what I can say in terms of Ghana City, probably if you are just getting started, you should be expecting like a minimum of 2,000, and the rest is above. I can't really say for the above, right? But at least a minimum of 2,000 salary should be good enough when you're just getting started.
Okay. What are some of the challenges you faced in your journey?
One of the big challenges when I want to like go into computer science, my dad was like, no. You know, parents are always like judging, they always be like, they want their kids to be maybe an engineer, a lawyer, this, that. So when I was like, I want to be a computer engineer, I was like, no, go for a mom. He was like, computer will go to extension and all of that, based on what he thought, but he doesn't have the vision I have. So it was very challenging. So I have to do geology. It's very stupid because it's not such a simple. Doesn't even relate with what I want to do, yeah.
So now you are enjoying what you are doing.
I did a course, geology, then I go back to science. So I'm fully in science. What is this making? Where I'm making money from is science, not from geology. I finished school like some years back. So yeah, but I'm back in lab. It's not like I'm back, I never left. So I'm fully into tech.
Okay, what inspire you or like get you motivated always in pursuing this career?
Okay. What motivates me now is that I just want to like build my own product. Like, I always fancy these guys, Mark, you know, Mars. So I just want to be like them. So basically, so that is what keeps me pushing it each and every time.
What's the reality truth about like the tech? People are posting like the fancy things we see on social media. Like, what's the actual truth about it? Like the harsh reality about the tech industry. Like what you've seen as compared to the social media, and what you are seeing in reality or your workplace.
Okay, I think this is actually general. Like on the internet, people make it seem like it's very easy. Fine, it may be very easy, but it's not. Like you need to like do a lot of hard work and the rest. And most importantly, you will see people like having overnight success. Frankly speaking, it's not just because overnight success. They've worked for it. Like they've practically been doing this kind of stuff for like years and the rest. And they've failed a lot. And probably you don't see those things, but it only, let's say, one of two products they do and it blow up and you think that it's simple. It's not simple. When you think it's simple, you give up very, very fast.
Well, everybody have different experience when it comes to like the tech journey, the tech career journey. So yeah, mine is different entirely. So I can't actually like, if you ask somebody, and if anybody, another person call me now, it can be like, it's the same, but mine is just a different experience entirely.
What are some of your future expectations?
My own future, I want to be a tech founder of a particular product, which I'm still working on. So yeah, I want to like be a very big, just like Elon Musk. So that's my expectation. Okay. Yeah, to be successful.
Okay. Through your journey, what you've learned, what one piece of advice will you give it to someone who is a new into tech or want to go into tech?
Man, what I would say is just like when you like I said, I've always wanted to be a science computer. I've always wanted to be into tech since primary school, although I don't know what it takes. But what I always say is that you should just follow your dream, follow the passion, and through it, always make research. Because every time I make research, I'm always like mind blown on the latest tech feature, whatever that comes through. I'm like, wow. So you have to stay updated, make research, and just follow your dream, follow your passion, because that's the drive to like stay put.
Thank you. Wow. I hope this gives you a glimpse into their world. If you enjoyed this video, then you are going to like the next video.